David Power. Let's...
Greetings and salutations. How's everybody doing today?
Fine.
Great.
Oh, well, I know spoken voice in the room. That's good. Happy to hear that. I'd like to thank all of you for inviting me out here today. So nice to be back in my little stomp and grounds, and hopefully share a little bit with you that might prove illuminating. And good donut, isn't it, Bernice? What's that noise? I've always wanted to say that. People are always saying that to me when I'm traveling around. They're going, what is that? I usually say, I have no idea. But anyways, let's get started with a little bit of magic here. It would be good to help. I usually do this particular effect with a lady, and I notice Bernice is eating the donut right now, so I'm a little bit... wonderful.
Big round of applause for her.
Thank you. Now, what we're going to do is get you to select a card here. Hopefully all of you can see it's an ordinary deck. Order and I'll get you, if you would, to just grab it. Sorry about that. That happens sometimes. I'm sure it'll be okay if we just wait a minute. Okay, so now they're okay. I'm going to get you to select a card. I don't want to see what it is, so I'll look away and just grab anyone. Grab a card and we'll do the trick. So if you just grab a card out, we'll Oh, thank you.
I'll put this one back.
Okay, yeah, that would be great. Okay, so she selected a card at random, and we're going to do a... you're not buying this at all. Okay, that's fine. We'll let you pick a different one, Brittany. So I appreciate you doing that. A couple of them caught on, so okay. If you would just grab another one.
Anyway,
we'll do a trick. Okay, so once again, she selected a card around. I'm going to get you to mark it, okay? Now, a lot of magicians, of course, they get people to mark cards with... Markers, that's right, yeah. You can do that. I can get her to mark with the marker. But I want to do something a little bit different. So instead, I'm going to get you, if you would please, Bernice, to just mark it with your scent.
With my
scent, your aroma, your odor, your... everyone has a unique scent. I didn't pick you for any particular reason. I don't want to feel that it's anything like that. But if you would just mark it up, rub it on your neck.
Worse.
Yes, there are. Nice to see you again. Okay, so anyways, it's a joke. Okay, if you would just rub it on your neck, just pick up the sand. Queen of Diamonds bit. Okay, now. If you would just rub it a little bit on the other side as well. And what the heck? I felt a little risky. A little decolletage, sure. They have taken a weapon right off there. I just thought maybe a discreet little knife would be fine. All right, that'll be just fine.
I want a preserve trick once because I had been able to show a preserve before any of the other magicians could get it out of their box.
I assure you. I believe it. Now, Bernice, what we'll do is we'll get you, if you want to just stick it in the deck anywhere you want. Makes it a lot easier. Okay, now we'll lose that off into the deck, and at this point I honestly don't know where it is, but I do know how to find it. All I'm going to do is make a little fan with the cards. Find the card by the sense of smell alone. Need a sample first. Very nice.
Avon.
Another sample. Thank you. Okay. I still can't find it. I thought so. Okay. No, I'll just try. Sure. Last lady I was doing it with, she was a bit of a drinker. I don't know if you can smell the alcohol in the cards or not. So, yeah, there's a... let's give her a round of applause.
Thank
someone else up to help here with something a little bit different. Let's see if we could, actually, you two guys right up in the front there, both of you will come up and help. That'd be fantastic. And you can just sit right there. And you can sit right there. Yeah, musical chairs. Okay. Very nice. Your name is?
Donovan.
Donovan, I'm David. And you are?
Ryan.
Ryan. Okay, nice to meet you, Ryan. Ryan, Donovan, David. Okay, now, Ryan, I'm Thomas. I do need to borrow what's on your screen. Hang on. Just the thing there. I'm not sure exactly what it is myself. It looks like it might be a coin. Like a silver dollar. Is that what it is? A silver dollar? Use this one as well. Now, with these coins, and you can examine them if you want. They're just ordinary silver dollars. Yeah, it was there. Okay, so we've got four coins. Thanks for playing, Donovan. And they are ordinary silver dollars, as you can see. You can examine them if you wish. Now, while you're looking at those, I'm just going to whirl these over here and then we'll get started. Now, there are just four of them. It's important that you know that. Four coins and four alone. I'll do this at the extreme fingertips. You can see everything is fair and honest. Just blow if you would. And now we have a three. One of the coins has melted away into nothingness. And I'll do that again for you. Even though nobody asked. Okay. We're just blow. Thanks, Donovan. Okay. Take the note that yet another coin has vanished going into nothingness. Now, Donovan, I'm going to do a generous word for tramped orders, hidden mirrors, concealed reptiles, floating ladies, things of that nature. And what, if anything, have you noticed about those?
Nothing.
Yeah, he's quick on his feet, though. Let me tell you a little story. This is funny. Probably most of you here know Murray Hatfield. I met him when I was about 10 or 11 years old. Having met him once at Mickey Hades, I saw him at Stampede. He goes, oh, nice to see you, Dave. Great. Yeah, I learned a new trick. Do you have any coins? And I go, yeah, sure. So I hand him a couple of the silver dollars that I used to do magic with. He goes, okay, just turn around so I can get set up. Okay, turn around. I know, waiting. And I turn around. He's halfway down the midway. I did get them back. But lively sense of humor, then, right? Okay, a little magic for you with two silver dollars, 10 steel spring fingers, and a body that just won't quit. Not actually a joke, but thanks. Okay, there we go. One over here and one over here. As you probably are aware, these are called flying eagles. It's because they have an eagle there because they like to fly. I'll do that again for you because sometimes people do miss it. But remember, the important thing is they are going to end up in the same hand in a moment. You heard that. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to start over. It's probably better. We'll just do it that way. I'll leave one up here and one down here, and that way, of course, I can't do sleight of hand. Now I can do sleight of mouth. Like, who does that? Now, with two coins, I realize it is hard to follow. That's why I'll probably just use one for the rest of this. It'll make it a lot easier. You want to look at it? Yeah, okay. Now, while he's examining that, we're going to use this one here. Tricky. See, it's a trained coin, so that does give me a bit of an advantage. A trained coin to tap dance across my fingers. And back again. It's like a homing coin, which is kind of neat. I've even trained the little guy to fall down. Good. Okay. All right. You don't like it when the coin's falling down. How about if I get to fall off? Would that be better? Thank you. Europe right now, if you're not aware of that. It's very popular. And I do a little bit of magic here with Sue. And you're welcome to those animals.
They're normal.
They're normal, yes. By magical standards, yeah. Sure. That's normal. Just like the ones you carry in your own purse. So we've got what? Economy signs, that's exactly what they are. So just like this. So this one doesn't work. it helps if you have one of these, right? Makes all the difference in the world if I try it. Blockbuster Panic.
I'll leave him protruding, if you will. Will you?
Yeah.
Okay. Just like that, it comes right back up to the top. So we're going to try this again. This time, Ryan, I'm going to get you actually to place it in yourself. I want you to take the four. I want you to push it